Good morning, everyone. I am D.S. Rajeshwari, TGT Social Studies, Kottakota, Mahabub Nagar, East Region. Welcome to Gnanadiksha program. Today, our session is Social Studies class. Before starting the class, I want to quote one quotation, Sanskrit proverb, that is, Ati Sarvatra Varjayet. Ati Sarvatra Varjayet. The meaning is, too much is too bad. What is too much here? Too much vacation, isn't it? Children, we all are getting bored at home by frozening our daily activities due to this COVID. So, we all are waiting for reopening of school and restarting our daily activities. But the situations are not allowing us to do so. So that our TSAT and our secretary sir, our TSWRS and TTWRS societies are providing Gnana Diksha program through online teaching classes. So we all should make use of them and get some knowledge even being at home. Okay, so today our session will be starting with a small conversation between a brother and sister. Brother was sitting so dull. Sister is asking, what happened, boy? Why are you so dull? Boy was asking the same thing which we have discussed just now. Sister, I am getting bored. When the school will reopen? I have so many doubts to clarify with my teachers, and I have to do much so much fun with my friends. So I am missing all these things. So what? When there was a school, you used it to be escape. Now you are trying to go to school. What is this? What doubts you have? Ask me. Let me try to clarify your doubts. Yeah, sister, I have one doubt. Please try to clarify. Before lockdown, we went to Sri Shailam Tribal Welfare Museum, isn't it? Chenchu Lakshmi Museum. Yeah, we went, sister said. So there, models are kept. Some men, women. The models were kept and they are doing different activities in forest and hilly areas. So I couldn't understand why these people are so. Why these people are doing different type of living activities. Why don't they are not like us? This is my doubt. Sister said, yes boy, the people will have different types of lifestyles where they live in. That depends upon the landscape which they live in. So that is the reason. So we are living in different areas, towns or cities, and those people are living on hilly areas, so that the lifestyles may be different. Okay, children, by this conversation, we have understood that the lifestyle of the people depends upon the landforms. Lifestyle of the people depends upon landforms. Today's our social studies topic is landforms and lifestyles, how they are related to our life. Landforms and lifestyles. So our lifestyle depends upon the landform. First, before knowing about this, we have to know what is a landform. A landform is a special geomorphic feature of the earth. A special geomorphic feature of the earth. Special geomorphic feature of the earth is called a landform. There are different types of landforms on the earth. You all know that earth is not even, it is uneven. So it has many ups and downs. So these are only called as different landforms. Let us see, there are different kinds of landforms. Let us see what are they. and what are the features, how they are affecting to our life. See, landforms are of three types. There are primary landforms, secondary landforms and tertiary landforms. The first one is primary landform. Secondary landform and tertiary. These three are different types of landforms formed on the earth. So these are of different types. Again, primary landforms means they are firstly formed landforms on the earth, first order landform. We also call them as first order landforms, firstly formed landforms. See, they are oceans and continent. Oceans and continents. Oceans and continents are the first order landforms or primary landforms. You all know that oceans, there are four big oceans and seven continents on the earth. These are the different primary landforms. Now let us see secondary landforms. Secondary landforms are of three types. Mountains, plateaus, plains. Mountains, plateaus and plains. So these are the three landforms which are comes under the secondary landform category. Now tertiary landforms. Tertiary landforms are so many tertiary landforms are there. They are different landforms like deltas, deserts, valleys, gorges, etc. There are many are there. So we will learn about tertiary landforms in different class. Now among these three landforms, primary, secondary and tertiary landforms, the major landforms are secondary landforms. Today we are going to know about them. Once we can see the pictures of primary, secondary and tertiary landforms, and then we go through the further topic. So these are the major landforms: mountains, plateaus and plains. These are also called secondary landforms. See this slide. You can see the oceans and the continents above, and below they are valley and sea cave, that is another one is sea arch. And there are deltas and deserts. You all know about them. So these all are included. Tertiary landforms are so many. So we will discuss about them later. Now let us see. First we will discuss about major landforms. Major landforms are first mountains. Mountains in major landforms, the first one is mountains. Mountains means they are highlands. You know, mountains are highlands with steeped slopes. They are very highlands on the earth and they are having steeped slopes, and there are very little flat area on it. Mountains are having very little flat area on it. So these are called mountains. And mountains, immediately we will remember Himalayas. When we say that mountains, immediately we will remember the Himalayan mountains. So these are the mountains in India and hills are in Telangana. So what is a hill and what is a mountain? Hill is a high land which is less than 600 meters. If it is above 600 meters of height, it is called as mountain. In Telangana, we have hills, not mountains. In India, there are different mountain ranges. You can see the slide. Himalayas, you can see Himalayan mountains and Aravali mountain range and Vindhya and Satpura range and Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats and so many other ranges are there, but these are the important ranges. So now mountains, the feature of mountain we have discussed, now it has a highland, steeped slopes, very little flat area on it. And now let us see how these mountains are providing livelihood. Actually, there is a small question. People, where do people like to live? People like to live in areas where they can find all amenities, where they feel it is comfort to live, isn't it? But mountain areas are not so comfort to live on. Mountains are hilly areas, are not suitable for movement. They are steeped slopes, so that the slope is down towards, so that we can't move freely on the hills and mountains. So that very little population we find on hills. So hills are providing very little population. They are thinly populated areas. And why these hilly areas are thinly populated means, there is little land for agriculture. The flat area is very, very minimized. So flat area only suitable for agriculture. So and soils are not so fertile. And water facilities are, irrigation facilities are not available. And there is no development. Modern amenities could not be provided on the hills easily. What are the modern amenities? Transportation and communication facilities, education, health, etc. Industrial areas could not be provided on the hills because it is not so comfort. Transportation is also not so comfort on the hills. So these hilly areas are not well developed, and people on hills, what is the lifestyle of the people? This kind of landform, how it is affecting the life of the people on the hills? Let us see. The people on hills are mostly tribal people. In India and Telangana, there are different tribal people are living, like Konda Reddys, Gonds, Savaras, Koyas, Chenchus, and other different type of tribal people. These tribal people who are living on the hills, they depend on the forest which is located on these hills, which is the forest covered by the hills. These forests only main source of livelihood for them. So they collect different forest products, and they also depend on hunting of small animals, and they don't have permanent settlement. They are nomadic people. They have no permanent settlement. They move here and there for their livelihood, in search of food, in search of occupation and all. So, and they also have to go to different longer distances to fetch even drinking water. In rainy seasons, they get some rain water stored in some ponds. But in non-rainy seasons, they have to go to longer distances to fetch a pot of water. So, it is very difficult life for them. And these people, they divide the work among themselves. Men, women and children also do work. Men will be engaged in farming work. Women and children will be collecting the forest products. Forest products with different types of forest products, honey and fruits, tubers, and especially bamboo and palm leaves, date palm and other palm leaves. They make different products with bamboo and other palm leaves. You can see this kind of products. You can see this kind of product. See, the people will make different types of baskets and other articles with the palm leaves and bamboo products. So, and they collect even fruits and nuts from the forest and they live on them. They prepare this different kind of bamboo products, articles, and they sell in the nearby weekly markets, and they live on that. And like this, their livelihood. And one more thing, the farming. Farming is the common activity in India for all the people. But even these people who are living on the hill also, they have farming as their activity, main activity, but only in rainy seasons. Rainy seasons, they cultivate the crops in on the hill slopes, and they have a different type of cultivation called podu cultivation. Podu farming. Podu farming is also called as jhum cultivation or shifting. Shifting farming, shifting cultivation, we call it. So, podu cultivation or podu farming or jhum cultivation or shifting cultivation, we call. So, what is meant by this podu farming? This is a special feature of the people living on hilly areas and forest areas. So, podu is a type of farming. They clear one patch of forest area, they clear one patch of forest area, and they burn the wood and the grass over that, and they start cultivating the crops when the rain will start. And after the soil lose its fertility few years, they shift from other from that place to another place, and they start the same activity over there. Same activity will be continued over there. So that is called a shifting. They shift from that place to another place. Now it is called a shifting cultivation. And this shifting cultivation, they won't ply the field on the hill slopes. They won't ply the field. Then how can they grow the crops without plying the field? They dig some holes on the land with a stick and they sow the seeds. Why plying is avoided here? The land is slope. If they ply the field, the soil will loosen and it will erosion when the rain will occur. So, the soil fertility will be lost very fast. Firstly, the soil will lose its fertility. So, that they don't ply the field, they dig the holes, they sow the seeds. So, the important crops on hills are mostly millets. Millets like bajra, ragi, korra, and vegetables, so on, jowar, different kinds of poor man's food we call, but nowadays they are becoming rich man's food. All the rich people who have who are increasing cholesterol and other heart diseases and other thing, in health conscious, the people are mostly they are concentrating on this kind of food. They are purchasing korras and jowar, ragi, they are eating that. And actually this food is grown and eaten by the hilly and forest area people, poor people, that too tribal people. Okay, so these are the crops. And rainfall is very seasonal. The farming also seasonal. But non-rainy seasons, what is the occupation of the people of this place? The occupation of people in non-rainy season is fetching forest products, hunting, and other kind of bamboo, collecting bamboo and making bamboo products and selling in the weekly markets. These are the different occupations. Okay, so these are the different features of the people, lifestyle of the people in hilly areas. So, children, is it different from us? Yes, yes, no? So, it is different like from when we compare to our life to the people on hilly areas, it is different. So, now let us come to hills in Telangana. We can see the hills in Telangana. We have seen in the slide mountains in India, Himalayas, Aravallis, Vindhya, Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. And when we come to Telangana, there are hills. So, these hills are different hills like Balghat Hills and Rakhi Hills, Satmala Hills, and Nirmal Hills. Okay, different hills are located in Devarakonda Hills and so on. So these are the different local names of these hills in Telangana. They are located in different districts. See, Anantagiri Hills in Vikarabad, Satmala Hills in Adilabad, and Nirmal Hills in Nirmal district, and Balghat Hills are in Mahabubnagar and Nagar Karnool districts. So these are the distribution of hills in Telangana. On these hills, there is we can see this kind of lifestyle which we have discussed just now. Okay, is it clear? Now let us move to plateaus, secondary landform, second one in secondary landform, that is plateaus. Plateaus. So plateaus are, they are also highlands with more flat area, and edges are steep, sloped. Okay. So this is land, highland. Plateaus are highlands. Plateaus are having more flat area when we compare to the hills or mountains, and the edges are steep sloped. The edges of the plateau has steep sloped. It look like a table land. So flat area, it is higher. It is having flat area and it is having steep slopes at the edges. Okay, plateaus are having a flat area, but it is not so flat. It also has many ups and downs, and it is also uneven. But when we compare to mountains, it is not so. It is having more flat area. So when we imagine what is a plateau and how it will be, there no need to go anywhere. We are on plateau itself. Telangana itself is a plateau. So we are living on a plateau. So now let us see, where are the plateaus in India and Telangana? See the slide. So there are two plateaus, Malwa Plateau and Deccan Plateau in India. So Malwa Plateau is also called as Northern Plateau. It is also having different parts like Chota Nagpur Plateau, Bundelkhanda Plain, Bagelkhanda Plain, etc. And Deccan Plateau is also called as Southern Plateau or Peninsular Plateau. It is the largest plateau in India. It is the largest plateau in India. Okay. And our state, Telangana, you can see Telangana map. See, what you are seeing in that? Lower Telangana plateau and upper Telangana plateau. So, total Telangana itself is in Deccan plateau. It is a part of Deccan plateau. Totally, it has some uplands and some lower plateau. So two plateaus are, lower plateau and upper plateau, according to its height. Okay, so this is the distribution of plateau. And let us see plateaus. The people in plateaus are living on agriculture and other different occupations, like different because plateaus are having more flat area, no? So they have they can take up agriculture. Black soils are there, and rainfall is normal to medium, and it is they are also taking up different transport and communication activities also, and so that the plateaus are provided with all facilities according to when the it is also related to the height of the land. When the height of the land is increasing, the facilities will be decreasing. So that is the thing. And when we when I said that Telangana is a plateau, we can compare our lifestyle with hills. That is, our life is normal life only we are leading, because it has more flat area and agriculture is possible. Paddy, groundnut, and cotton, these all are the different crops grown here. And water facilities are rain fed cropping is more common. And one more thing, tank irrigation is most suitable on plateaus. You know that Mission Kakatiya, which is introduced by Telangana government. Mission Kakatiya is developing tank irrigation in Telangana, because it is most suitable for us. Tank and well irrigation are most common. And next, let us come to plains. plains are most level lands on the earth. They are provided with alluvial soils, the most fertile soils on the earth. Alluvial soils and black soils are provided, and rainfall is plenty because they are leveled area, they are flat area. So, complete flat, they are not more above the sea level. So that plains are provided with all modern amenities, and these are also included with deltas. Delta means it is a land, delta is a land which is formed by rivers by depositing silt. Before joining to the sea, the rivers are forming the deltas. So, there are Krishna Delta and Godavari Delta in Andhra Pradesh, and there are no plains in Telangana. When we want to take an example in Telangana, there are no plains at all. Okay. So, plains are provided with all kinds of amenities and industrial areas and irrigation facilities, like canal irrigation is suitable, tank irrigation is suitable, well irrigation is suitable, and groundwater table is very higher in plains. So, that people in plains are very happy to live on it. There are Indo-Gangetic plains in India. Indo-Gangetic plains, Indus and Ganges rivers are they are formed. Indus plains and Ganges plains, both are called Indo-Gangetic plains, largest plains in India. So, largest plains and highly thickly populated areas in India, thickly populated areas, because plains are provided with all facilities, no? So that most people live on plains. And there are some coastal plains, east coastal plain and west coastal plain. Coastal plains also provided with all facilities, and these coastal people have fishing as their main activity, fishing and salt making. Okay, children, so to recap with, you can go through these slides with differences between mountains, plateaus and plains, like rocky soils, infertile, steep slopes and rain, and plateaus you can see red soils, black soils, chowdhury soils, they are not so fertile soil, and tank and well irrigation. Plains, you can see alluvial, black soil, sandy soil, and they are more fertile soils on the earth, and rainfall is very plenty, canal and well irrigation are suitable for this. And you can see lifestyle, mountainous people are forest dwellers, and podu cultivation is the common cultivation here. Plateaus are suitable for farming, sheep rearing and cattle rearing also main occupation here in plateaus, and plains are having farming and fishing, salt making as their occupations. You can see along with this, we can see this chart, you can see. What is this? Polar regions. These are the different landforms on the earth. Polar regions. The people living on permanent ice sheets, ice covered area. These people are called Eskimos. Eskimos, they live in ice, the house made of ice called igloo. The house made of ice called igloo. And see, these people are called Eskimos. See how they are dressing style, and they live on hunting and fishing, and the very hard life they are living on these permanent ice sheets. See that you can't see land on this picture, totally covered by ice. So, these are the different types of landforms on the earth which makes our life so different. According to these landforms, we have so different lifestyle. Okay, children, I think you have understood. And now let us go to project. Today's project is, compare the lifestyle of people in your area with the lifestyles of the people living in different landforms. And the second one is, prepare a model of major landforms by using clay and pebbles. Major landform means mountains, plateaus, plains, you make one model by using clay and pebbles. And children, enjoy with this session. I think you have enjoyed by this session, and enjoy by doing a project also, and submit to your teachers, and stay home and stay safe and stay knowledgeful also. So, our society is giving knowledge to you. through these classes. Okay, thank you.